to the Mordork podcast, where you can't simply walk into Mordor, but you can simply listen to the Mordorks. We are your less than professional hosts, Carson and Aaron, and welcome to the show.
Yeah, welcome to that show.
Was that the most professional opening I've ever done?
That was really good. I like your voice sounded very authoritative. It's do that.
I tried to deepen it a little. I feel like my voiceover is going Shatner.
Spock. Yeah, guys. Welcome back to another week. Hope you survived your week pretty fine. We're here to talk about all things nerdness, nerd news, a random topic that I kind of just pull out of the air every week, and
at least until there's like actually like a topic to talk about.
Basically, yeah. Starting off with our first segment, the news. Let's talk about some stuff that has happened over the past week, or at least things that I think are pretty interesting. here's something that's pretty interesting. So Toho, after swearing that they would never make another Godzilla movie, has made another Godzilla movie. It was called Shin Gojira, and basically it was kind of their attempt to cash in on the popularity that the 2014 Godzilla here in America started to cause, and it's been released in Japan, and it's been doing very well, surprisingly, and they're actually going to be releasing it limited here in American theaters here in North America. Not sure about which theaters, if they will be near me or not, but that sounds pretty cool. And it's going to be released next month in October. And it's
perfect
going under the official
Halloween.
Exactly, yeah. Here's the interesting thing. It's going to be called Shin, like the official English name is like Shin Godzilla, which I think is interesting. They're keeping the Japanese part of that name because no one knows what Shin means. Like, you can Google it, and essentially why they picked that name was because it can mean like three different things in Japanese. Apparently, like it can mean like new or like rebirth or something. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. But anyways, Carson,
it matters to the Japanese, dadgummit.
Yeah, are you interested in this? No, keeping in mind that you've never seen a Japanese Godzilla movie?
I've liked some things that Japan has produced. I mean, I want to
as a country overall, they've released some good things.
Yeah, I mean, I'm starting off broad and I'm going to get more specific. Video games, movies, I mean, they produce things that I've liked, and so, but, I don't know, I'd have to see reviews, because, in general, Godzilla, I know that I'm going to get crap for this, because this used to be your channel, and you used to, like, have a lot of Godzilla-related stuff on the channel, so.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about, man.
So I'm going to get crap for this, but. Personally, Godzilla has never been something that I've been super interested in, mm-hmm. And so I'd have to hear, you know, good things about it for me to hear.
Now, if I kidnap you and make you watch this movie, do you think you would go watch it?
Yeah, I'd watch it with you.
Okay. I'm actually super, kind of interested to see about this, because, I mean, I watched the international trailer, which was basically just the Japanese trailer, but with no voices. So I'm interested to see, first of all, if they're going to dub over it or if they're just going to do subtitles. And also, like, the Godzilla in this movie looks really weird. Like, it's kind of almost like a zombie Godzilla. It's like, gigantic. Like, it's bigger than the 2014 one. So they're just trying to up every time. They're trying to, like, outdo the legendary Godzilla at every turn. I don't know. It looks kind of interesting. Who knows what'll happen? Anyways, next thing. So we've been following this for a few months now. The Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 4 is going to be coming out, and as they've been really advertising these last few weeks, Ghost Rider is going to be showing up in it. And they're really pushing that aspect of it, so it's like he's going to be a main, like I'm assuming he's going to be kind of a main character of the season the way they're really advertising it. And we've actually gotten our first look as Gabriel Luna as Robbie Reyes, and I gotta be honest, man, it kind of looks cool. I mean, he looks exactly like he does in, you know, in the comics. So I mean, he's got the jacket. I mean, he's got the hairstyle, the look. You know, I mean. It looks like him. You know, we still haven't seen what the actual Ghost Rider part of him is going to look like, but I think, you know, it looks cool. I gotta say, it kind of looks cool. I'm a little excited about it, even though this really isn't how I wanted to see Ghost Rider turn up in a Marvel thing. You know, I would have much rather to see Johnny Blaze, but I mean, you know, anything to make Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. more interesting. have you seen this, or do you care?
Yeah, I've seen it, and I'm kind of in the same boat as you.
Yeah, I mean, it looks cool, but...
I mean, it looks cool, but I'm not... I don't know, I kind of... Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is, like, the least interesting aspect of the MCU, in my opinion, and so I'd kind of be okay with them shutting it down and taking the... and using those resources elsewhere.
Yeah, exactly. So, I don't know. Also, I really want to see Johnny Blaze for real, though. Like, I just get rid of the entire Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. show and just, like, make a Netflix season of Ghost Rider and I'll be super happy.
That would be awesome.
That would be super awesome. Okay. So, I don't know. Do you remember the rumor a while ago that DC was trying to develop a Krypton series for sci-fi, for the sci-fi channel?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you remember, like, that's actually still happening. Did you know that?
Yeah, I did, which, I think it's
mind-boggling how this is actually happening. Yeah, it's a stupid idea. It's like...
I mean, like, at least, I know that you disagree, but Gotham, I didn't really care that much for. I felt like it had some decent ideas, but it didn't execute on a lot of them very well. At least Gotham, like, it opens the door for a lot of possibilities. Yeah. Whereas Krypton, it's like, we kind of know how it ends. And so exactly. The only thing I can really think that it would be, quote, about would be, like, one Jor-El trying to get his son, Superman, off of the planet, which they'd have to pretty much save for the last season.
Well, here's
setting up villains, which, like, Zod, or do, like, the Superman animated series thing where Brainiac is from Krypton.
Right, yeah. So, well, here's the crazy
thing.
But
I feel like
actually,
it's very limited.
Yeah, well, this show is supposed
to... Sorry,
like,
I keep interrupting you.
It takes... This show actually takes place two generations before that. So Jor-El's not even going to be in it. It's his father. So it's the grandfather of Kal-El. Yeah, I
had not heard that. Probably because I wasn't like paying attention to the news. Just because I was kind of like, I kind of feel it's kind of inherently a stupid idea to make a whole TV show. Like I could see like maybe a mini series. Like if they wanted to set up a villain that was Kryptonian, but
yeah,
like I said, like you know do. Zod or Brainiac, like they did make Brainiac from Krypton, or show how Doomsday was created, like the comic version of Doomsday, making him like, or you know, like show like the Kryptonian aspect of that story.
Yeah, I mean that's the things you just named are really the only things interesting you could do with this, other than just turn it into like a weird Game of Thrones in space sort of thing, you know, with just like. You know, the different houses of Krypton, you know, the different political families.
Yeah, but the thing is like, that, like, with that, it's going to be hard to get us to care because everybody knows that not too long after that, Krypton's going to explode.
Exactly, yeah. I don't know, man. It's kind of, it's like, what are you guys doing?
I mean, like, you know, I'm okay
with...
What
are you doing, guys?
Taking, like, new approaches to superhero storytelling and maybe... But in kind of doing, like, the origin, like, or not even the origin, but like a story based in the universe, but before they become the superhero. But
yeah.
Pick a superhero whose origin lends itself to a better story.
Exactly, yeah. Like, they did Smallville for like 11 seasons, and then, I guess, you know, after that turned out, they're like, all right, let's just go even further back, before he was even born. Okay, well, that's, I mean, are you gonna at least see the first episode, just to see what they're doing?
Yeah, I'll probably try to see the first episode, at least.
Yeah, it's also on the Sci-Fi channel, which is like where all weird TV shows...
It's like where TV shows that we go, TV shows and movies, well, more movies. It's where movies go that we make fun of.
Yeah, exactly, it's like, I don't know.
That's where you make a movie about, that's a reinterpretation of Moby Dick, but where the whale is now a dragon. I'm not kidding.
That thing?
Yeah, that exists. I watched through it all. It was horrible. There was a huge plot, so many plot holes.
Was it still like, you know, like sea captain?
No, they were a land captain. Like, they had like this...
A land captain?
I mean, they had like this like wagon, armored wagon that they like took around with them hunting dragons. They were hunting, but the main dragon they wanted to catch was the white dragon. And
I don't know, man. Sounds like we need to make a TV show out of this.
I mean, honestly, like conceptually, that would make a better story than Krypton, in my opinion. Just because that concept doesn't have rules, or the only rules it has are what the writers impose on themselves from the beginning, you know, and they can go anywhere. Whereas, like with Krypton, you pretty much have to have the planet destroyed.
Yeah, Krypton basically only exists to explode.
Yeah, I mean that's kind of cynical, but yeah, that's exactly right.
Yeah. Also, we don't know if this is going to tie into the DCEU or not.
I don't think it will. I would probably be shocked if it did.
Yeah, it'll just be its own weird little thing. Okay, so here's an idea for a show that's not ridiculous. A Black Lightning show is currently being developed by Greg Berlanti, who also had a hand in Arrow, Flash, and Legends of Tomorrow. And it's not clear whether it's going to be part of the CW Arrowverse or not. Because apparently he's, you know, trying to get different networks to take it. But it's apparently going to focus on Black Lightning, who, if you don't know, is a DC African American hero who is like electric powers, kind of. That's just basically what he does. He's also got two kids, also one named Thunder, one named Lightning, who eventually go off to do their own superhero things. And this show is apparently, I think, about him having these kids, and he's, like, retired, and he's, like, going to take up the mantle again because, like, one of his kids is in trouble or something like that. So, I mean, it's an interesting, you know, interesting premise, and, you know, like, taking Black Lightning and making a show about him, That sounds pretty interesting.
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea if it's executed well.
Yeah. Like, I don't know a lot about him, honestly, as a character, but I think, you know, this, at least the premise of this show sounds like it could be very cool. And obviously, if it ties into the CW verse, then, like, I'm all for more of that, you know. That's, like, the best thing DC's doing right
now.
Yeah,
I mean, it's better than the DCEU, in my opinion.
Yes, yes. I mean, if you're listening and you don't think that, it's okay, but you're wrong.
It's okay, listener. You can be wrong if you want to.
You can be wrong. Perfectly allowed to be. But yeah, so I think this is an awesome idea for a show. Always glad to see old Greg at it again.
Old Greg.
Okay.
I hate and love my roommate for showing me that video.
Oh. What?
Old Greg. You've never seen that YouTube video? Or it's from a show. I forget what the name of the show is.
Cory in the House?
No. Don't watch the Old Greg video.
Okay, guys, go out and watch that, whatever it is. All right. Next thing is Stranger Things, that show that we both like.
The one that just got renewed for season 2. Oh, did I just steal your news?
Oh, snap, you just stole my news. Yeah, that's just got released for renewed for a second season, and that's pretty awesome, because that show is really good. Isn't that right?
Yeah, I don't have anything to add to this. I stole your news, and now I don't have anything to add to it.
you slipped up. You slipped up, Carson. You slipped up. Okay. Here's, I think, the biggest thing that happened this week. So Ben Affleck.
I know where this is going to.
Having a hand. Ben Affleck has some sort of creative hand in the development of the Justice League movie. He has released a video of what appears to be test footage of Deathstroke. Now, whether or not this is going to be in... Now, people obviously are wondering, well, where's he going to show up? Is he going to be in Justice League? Is he going to be in the Batman movie, which may come out in, 2 years? You know, also, who is playing him? How much of a role will he have? Your thoughts on this guy? Does he look cool?
I wasn't 100% satisfied with the costume, I don't know. I liked it, but I thought that there were maybe some small improvements that could be made. But honestly, that's secondary to the actor, which I don't have an actor in mind. I mean, Manu Bennett did. I may be pronouncing that wrong, but he did a great job on Arrow. It felt like a new take, because I'm not used to thinking of Deathstroke with that thick accent. But I thought he did a great job. And that was another case where, maybe the costume could have used some improvement, but obviously they were on a budget. And, the acting really carried it. And so, you know, I didn't mind the costume, so I'm hoping that's what will happen with this movie, if they don't alter the costume in any way. But I don't really have anybody that I could think of right off the top of my head.
A fan favorite for this role has been John Manganiello, who you may remember as Flash Thompson from the Sam Raimi Spider-Man movies. He's been in a lot of other things, too, but that's just, the first thing that comes to mind.
I don't know. I have a hard time seeing that personally, but that's just because I keep seeing him as Flash Thompson.
He was in Magic Mike, you know? Seen that?
I did not see that.
Your favorite movie?
And then I would imagine that he'd probably show up in the Batman movie as opposed to Justice League, because Justice League is already going to be crowded. Which then again, DC has developed a habit for overcrowding their movies, so maybe he will be in Justice League. But I feel like
he's just going to make a small cameo in Justice League and then show up more in Batman.
But I honestly, with the other rumors that we're hearing about the Batman project, it makes me kind of think that even in that movie, he won't have a huge part.
Yeah. as for how it looks, though, I feel like it really is, kind of taking inspiration from the Arkham Origins Deathstroke. Kind of, more armored up and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
but I don't know. It looks all right. I just hope that it's in a good movie.
Me too.
pretty cool. All right, so the last thing here is there's been a lot of TV news today. The last thing is Marvel is trying to develop a new Warriors TV show, which will be set as more of a comedy, and it will be kind of like a young Avengers, like the teenagers superheroes sort of thing. And one of the main characters is supposedly going to be Squirrel Girl. And as you know, a few weeks ago we said that fans were really that Anna Kendrick had said that, you know, she would be fine with playing Squirrel Girl because a lot of people have picked her. Because I'm not sure why, but I think this could be interesting. It's always cool to see kind of a mixing of genres when it comes to these kind of movies, because, with Deadpool, that was a comedy, a weird meta-comedy, and also a superhero movie, and I feel like there's probably what Marvel's trying to do, not it's probably more family-friendly, but make it, blend comedy and superhero action with this new Warriors show. So I don't know. What do you think? Is this a show? Could this make a show?
I mean, honestly, there are a few ideas that wouldn't make a good show if they were well executed. So yeah, I think this could make a good show. One thing that is kind of like popping out to me as we're talking is just how many superhero shows there are or are in development.
Yeah.
And one thing that I'm kind of a little apprehensive about is overpopulation, so to speak.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, oversaturation of the market. Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts on that? Like, are we rushing a little bit too headlong into the superhero TV show?
I don't
I'm
know.
A nerd, and so I love
yeah, it gives us stuff to talk about.
I love superheroes. I love Marvel. I love DC whenever they've actually got their act together.
Yeah.
So I'm perfectly happy, but I like to also look at kind of the big picture, and I'm wondering, like, maybe if, like, people who aren't like us might get a little sick of the superhero shows.
Yeah, well, like, you know, people have been saying that about the movies for years now, eventually it's going to fall through.
Yeah, but
and I feel like...
Is like if Marvel puts out 2 movies a year, DC puts out 2 movies a year, and Fox puts out a movie or 2 movies a year, then we're getting, like, then there's at least, we're at least getting, like, 2 months between each movie.
Yeah.
Theoretically, like, if they're evenly spread out. So, like, you know, there's at least a little bit of a break in for the movies, whereas, like, you know, superhero TV shows, they're on a weekly basis.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I feel like there's a possibility that the if these different shows can sort of have their own spin, their own take on the genre, then I feel like maybe they can kind of differentiate themselves enough. Like if one's like a wacky comedy and the other one's like a super serious like crime thriller sort of thing, you know, like if you can vary it up a bit, then I feel like people maybe just won't notice. But yeah, I mean, there's just so many, it's almost like currently there's so many, it's hard enough to keep track of it as it is. And if you add all these others that are supposedly going to be made within the next 2 years, then yeah, it's, you know, it's starting to get a lot. And I don't know.
Yeah, I mean,
it's
like,
it's going to be interesting to see what people will accept, you know.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan, like I've said, of Flash and Arrow, but I fell behind, and like, so I'm waiting for the seasons to come out on Netflix so I can catch back up.
Yeah.
And so obviously I, as a huge fan, have had a hard time keeping up, and just thinking about like all these other shows, like how, you know, it's going to be even harder to keep up with all of them, and I don't think I can, so I'm probably just going to have to pick my favorites. And so I'm just wondering, like, how much, you know, if there's all these superhero shows, is it going to become oversaturated for somebody who isn't passionate about superheroes like I am?
Yeah.
So that's,
I don't know.
I kind of had to take a cynical into the news section. Kind of a cynical, depressing look.
I don't know. I mean, well, who knows? Maybe that's their plan, is to, like, flood the market so much that people literally can't see everything they make, so that, like, they'll tell their friends to watch the things they can't see, so that they can, like, both, you know, talk about different things. I don't know. Who knows? I am not a Swami, Carson. I don't know the future.
Well, get to work on that.
Okay, guys. That brings us to our main topic, our main talking point today, which is, as you may remember, last week we talked about DC's movies and their track record so far, how it's not been exactly spotless. So this week we decided to even it out with talking about Marvel's future. Now, here's the first thing. Phase 3 is the next bunch of movies that'll be coming out for Marvel through, like, I think 2019. So that's 3 years from now. And they've basically announced every movie they're going to be making from now till then, and it's all going to basically culminate with an untitled Avengers 4 movie.
That was previously Infinity War Part 2.
Right, yes. And it's going to have something to do with Avengers 3. So
Thanos, it'll be connected. Infinity Gauntlet, all that.
Yeah, so it'll be... But so that's basically going to be the swan song. Everything that has led up till now that started with Iron Man in 2008. And this is also an important point, because a lot of the main actors who have been around since the beginning, Robert Downey Jr., Chris Evans, Chris Hemsworth, Jeremy Renner, all them, their contracts are going to be up. They're going to be ending. So it's pretty much assumed at this point that most, if not all, of the original Avengers will be walking away after this fourth one, which has led people to wonder, well, like, what's going to happen next? Are they going to recast them? Are they going to try to do what they do in the comics and pass the mantle onto some completely different character? Or are they just going to have the already established characters like Vision and Scarlet Witch have a more, involved role? And so what we're going to do here today is kind of just talk about what we think may happen in Phase 4. So, Carson, would you like to see Iron Man, Captain America, Hulk, all them recast? Or would you want to see maybe someone like that's already established take a bigger role? Because it seems like they're really expanding the roster here, and that's what some people are assuming may happen. So, like, instead of, Iron Man, we'll have Doctor Strange be a huge part,
First of all, Iron Man needs to die. Flat out die.
Oh, you think he needs to die? Like, straight up die?
Yeah, somebody has to at least one hero has to straight up die. I mean, Thanos is a huge threat. Quicksilver died against Ultron, and Thanos is supposed to be so much bigger than Ultron. So somebody needs to die. That makes sense. I am actually a big fan of death. Okay, as weird as that sounds, but
death in
or here's what I mean. I like it whenever writers find clever ways to kill off characters in meaningful ways, because you can do so much with that.
Yeah.
Because one, it raises the stakes, but even more than that, it can help build other characters. It can help it as they react to the death, as they react to the fact, as they have to they have to face their comrade's death, and it cements the fact that they're risking their own lives and the lives of the people they care about.
Yeah,
so. I think Iron Man should die, but don't do like in Cyclops and X-Men The Last Stand. Don't kill him off screen. Make it a meaningful death where he dies doing something important where we are going to remember him. A heroic sacrifice.
Right.
And I think that makes sense also, because of all the Marvel heroes, I really think that Robert Downey Jr. would be the hardest to recast, just because
he's
so perfect in that role. Like, Marvel's done an amazing job casting all of them, but we've already survived one transition with Hulk. I'm kind of the fan of the idea of Captain America surviving, but then, like, passing the mantle down to either Bucky Barnes or Sam Wilson.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that... I don't know, I'd really like to see Bucky become Captain America at some point.
I do know that Sebastian Stan, the guy who played Bucky, at one point said that he didn't really want Bucky to become Captain America, or at least not at the point where they were at, which this
was before
Civil War, so I don't know if he'd be interested in staying that long or becoming Captain America. But from the storytelling perspective, like, if Chris Evans is leaving, like, I'd kind of like to see it passing the mantle. But I do think overall, after Infinity War, they probably should, like, start, like, highlighting, like, heroes that we haven't seen very much of or haven't been around in the movie universe as long as the main Avengers. you know, maybe
yeah.
some of them around. I don't know. I mean, are the Russo brothers planned to direct Avengers 4? I know they're doing the third one.
Yeah, I don't know, actually. I think that's what they're doing, but I'm not, you know, I guess I'm not sure.
I think so, too, and honestly, right now, I have complete trust in them, so I think that they'll
yeah.
figure I really do think that somebody needs to die, but
mm-hmm.
I think they'll figure out, I think they'll figure out a way to make it meaningful, pick the person who makes the most sense within the themes of the movie, and, like, right now, I just have complete faith in them, so I think they'll figure out
yeah.
how to do it well.
But do you think, okay, so like if they don't do that, would you be a fan of maybe them recasting them? Because keeping in mind that they have done that already once with the Hulk, and even though they really don't, like, you know, Marvel really doesn't like to, they just don't really feature that movie, The Incredible Hulk, that much. They don't, like, I think they just try to forget that it happened.
Yeah, which is sad, because I feel like it's an underrated movie. I really like The
yeah.
Hulk. But I think also because the rights are kind of tied up with, is it Paramount? Or Universal?
Universal. Yeah. Yeah.
But so
I don't know. Like, we've seen...
too.
Yeah. Like, we've seen that happen once already, and no one really made a big deal out of it. So would they just do it again with other characters? Like, way more prominent characters?
I
don't know.
Feel
like
they could, and like people might whine about it for a little while, but then they'd get over it. But like I said, I really want Iron Man to go out heroically and.
Mm-hmm. This might be.
Four.
Yeah. I mean, you know, here's what Marvel does a lot. They set up their movies in their comics in a lot of ways. And I feel like now that the movies are, like, the biggest thing they've got going, they've been doing that more than ever. And you'll notice that in the comics right now, which I don't really read the comics that much, but I do occasionally look into what they do. And they, you know, they've been passing on the mantles of their classic characters who've been those characters for decades onto other people. And, you know, they've been going back and forth on that, obviously. But I feel like that's kind of laying the groundwork. And I think they're doing this consciously, that they're laying the groundwork for future movies for when, in the movies, you won't be able to have Chris Evans stay Captain America. So you'll have to move it on to somebody else. Because in a lot of way, you know, in a way, I feel like recasting would just be so, like, too much of a shock to people. Like, it'd be too jarring to just walk into an Avengers movie and see somebody completely different.
Yeah,
because
like
the Hulk, it wasn't... With the Hulk, it didn't really matter that much because a lot of people didn't see that movie. And, you know, it just didn't change that much. And plus, now, he was only in the one movie. And now we've
yeah.
seen Mark Ruffalo in, like, three movies. So, but, like, if you did try to do that with anybody else, like Thor or Cap or Iron Man, like, it's just going to be too jarring, you know. People will not take well to that. So I think the only way you can really go after this is to just pass the mantle along to, like, a Bucky or Falcon or somebody, you know.
They technically don't even have to, like, pass the mantle. They could just, like, hang up the, quote-unquote, cape and cowl, you know, and just, like, that
yeah.
hero is retired.
Yeah, I mean, that's the other thing they could do, is just not have a Captain America anymore. Just have, you know, whatever. But then you got to ask, like, you know, in the Avengers, can you have an Avengers without a Cap or an Iron Man or a Hulk or a Thor?
I mean,
can
the
it
thing
be
is,
just
the
Vision
Avengers,
and Scarlet Witch and,
I mean,
like, some others?
The Avengers roster does switch out a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, we've seen it in the movies, but... You know, we see it in the comics all the time. We see it. We've already seen it in the movies, like the roster get changed up. So,
isn't there
yeah.
always the same? At least one of the, like, original people part of the Avengers at some point.
Yeah. So,
it just seems like that would be weird, you know.
Yeah. So maybe they shouldn't kill. Maybe here's what they do: they don't kill off Iron Man, but they just keep him in the suit. Like, we don't.
It's just his voice from, like, clips from all the other movies cut together.
Or, like, he makes the suit sound more robotic so we can't even recognize his voice, so anybody can.
Yeah. Or maybe they just reconstruct him with CGI, you know?
I mean, like, I don't know. I mean, it's kind of hard to, like, speculate, like, what should happen because, one, we're not behind the scenes, and two, it's so far out. And honestly, there's a part of me as a storyteller or as a that I kind of feel like, as a storyteller, I am a big fan of going out on a high note, going out on a big note. So there, even though I love the MCU, there is kind of a part of me that's kind of like, well, how do you top Thanos and the Infinity War that with what you have? And so maybe it might not even. I mean, I know that they're not going to do this, and I'm actually glad that they're not going to do this. But still, from a storytelling perspective, I kind of see like maybe it might be best to end it with Avengers 4.
Oh, so you think there maybe even shouldn't be a Phase 4?
No. That's not what I'm... Like, I'm kind of at war with myself about if there should be...
Like, that...
There's going to be. Like, yeah. There's the part of me that's a fan of these characters and, that, like, want to see them and see new characters. But then there's another part of me that's, like, that is the storyteller. As a storyteller, like I said, I'm a fan of ending on a big note. And I can't think of... And it's hard for me to think of something that Marvel could do that would be bigger than Avengers 4. So the storyteller says, you know, it might be good to end it. You know, it's kind of like Supernatural. Like, Supernatural is on is going into its like 12th season.
Yeah.
You know, I'm behind on that show too. But like I said that the series really should have ended after season 5. Like, I've enjoyed the seasons after, like, afterward, but, from a storytelling perspective, season 5 was where it should have ended. Like, because that would have been the high note, and now it's going to be hard for them to reach a high note quite that high, and so I'm kind of, and so the storyteller in me would rather the Avengers and the MCU go out on a high note than, like, keep trying to do something and end up slowly trickling out.
Yeah, that's kind of the thing.
But then there's the part of me that's a big fan of these characters and doesn't want to see them go. So maybe the perfect marriage of my two sides is basically kind of like, you know, start focusing completely on the new characters. You know, kind of.
That's kind of the problem that the comics has had for like decades is like trying to, you know, find a good compromise between staying true to the original ideas and the original characters and like also trying to come up with new things to do. And maybe if they did kind of end it, that would be like the finally, after all these decades, like a way to kind of put these characters to rest, you know, like finally give them a good ending, you know, which would be sad to do, but that would still like almost be like good in a way, you know what I mean?
Yeah, maybe maybe what they should do with the MCU is kind of make that the ending for that set of heroes. Like maybe like completely shift to the next generation. I don't know. Like I said, I'm kind of poor, and fortunately, I'm not the person who has to take into account both the storytelling aspects and the logistics and the financials and the actors and all of that, so I don't...
Yeah.
Because, you know, Marvel also has to be considering, like, what's going on behind the scenes.
Right,
so,
yeah.
So, fortunately, I'm not the guy they're looking to answer all those questions, but I don't know, I'm kind of at war with myself about that.
Yeah.
You know, and once again, I just want to emphasize, I'm not saying that I don't like these characters or that I don't want to see them anymore. It's just, I really do like going out on a high note in my stories, and so I'd rather see them end well and end strong than continue on and not really have any good ideas, or the ideas to slowly get less and less until eventually the MCU just trickles out. I'd rather go out in a blaze of glory.
Exactly, yeah, that's like... Yeah, part of me kind of wants that to happen too, but I don't know. So, okay, assuming that it continues, which it likely will, and assuming that we see new characters show up, what kind of new movies would you want to see? Like, I'm thinking, like, we'll see new solo movies, but I'd also like to see team-up movies too, you know? Like, Thor Ragnarok seems to be going for, like, a Hulk-Thor team-up. And I think if that turns out to be successful, that would be really cool to see in the future. So, like, I don't know, like, maybe like a movie where we see one or two, or like two or three characters, already established characters, kind of team up and do their own thing. Like, would that be something that could happen?
Maybe. I mean, ever since the Avengers came out, that kind of opened the floodgate for the MCU to do these movies where these characters, like, appear in each other's movies, and that's only been increasing going forward.
Yeah.
So I definitely see that as a possibility.
Yeah, I don't know. I just think that in a world that they've, this world that they've created now, like, there should be no reason why they can't just, you know, a couple of them just go off and do their own thing. Because that's like it is in the comics too. You know, we see, you know, two or three characters team up to do something, and, you know, that's just like their own little thing, and it doesn't have to be everybody, but it doesn't have to be just one person. You know, one person, like one character, doesn't have to be, have just their movie, you know?
Yeah.
So, I don't know, I think that'd be an interesting thing to see. But what new characters would you want to see actual movies dedicated to? Like, introducing new ones, you know?
Yeah, well, that's kind of a hard question. The question of moving forward itself is hard, but I think it's compounded by the fact that there are a lot of characters that Marvel still doesn't have the rights for.
Yeah, that's the thing.
And so, I guess I'm more thinking villains right now. Like, you know, like, I was thinking of Doctor Doom and Galactus and those. Those maybe follow-up villains. But as for heroes, this is really,
it sucks. Question. One thing sucks for one, because Fox owns rights to two major, you know, aspects that I really want to see done well. You know, like, I want to see a good Fantastic Four movie in the MCU, and I don't think that's going to happen, but I mean, it could. But what's even less likely is an X-Men MCU movie, and obviously that would be awesome too, but I don't think that'll happen anytime in the near future at all. But as for, like, new characters, I think it would be cool to, like, do more, like intergalactic stuff, you know? Like, space, like, explore more of the space aspect. Because right now all we've done really is Guardians of the Galaxy. And by the time Phase 3 is over, we'll have seen Thor Ragnarok, which is supposed to take place more in space, and Captain Marvel as well. And I think we could, like, expand
Nova,
on that.
Nova.
Yeah, I was just going
to
say.
I like, had him in my mind before we started recording, and I was like, okay, you gotta remember Nova.
Yeah. I think Nova would be a great one to do, because a main, like, that character starts off as, you know, was it Richard Rider? Something like that. But it's, you know, the guy who becomes Nova first, and then he passes it on to his son. And I think that would be a really natural progression, because that's, like, a big part of that character in the comics. I think we could see that done really well in the movies as well.
Do you think an Adam Warlock movie?
Should see him in Avengers Infinity War, so it would be nice to see, like, a solo, maybe. Like, a weird, cerebral sort of, like, weird sort of movie like that, I think would be really cool to see.
Yeah, they'd have to be really careful with that one.
Yeah.
Like, that's... But then again, like, Doctor Strange is showing that they're not afraid to step into the weird.
Yeah.
Then again, Guardians of the Galaxy showed us they weren't... That has a talking raccoon. They showed us a long time ago they weren't scared to step into the stranger elements of the universe, and I think that embracing those elements has helped a lot.
Yeah. Here's another one that I don't think will happen, but... And even if they did do it, it would probably be too much like a Guardians of the Galaxy ripoff, or that's like what people would think. But I think the Starjammers would make an awesome movie just to see. You know, like the Starjammers, if you guys don't know, is like first appeared in the X-Men comics and is basically a team of various intergalactic outlaws that are from various races and alien races, and the leader is a human from Earth. So it's basically, I know it sounds exactly like Guardians of the Galaxy, and it's only because it is. It's exactly like Guardians of the Galaxy. But the Starjammers actually, I think, predates the version of the movie, the Guardians of the Galaxy movie, those guys by like a few decades, I think. But obviously the only problem there is that, you know, I'm pretty sure the rights to those characters are owned by Fox right now. So we'll probably not see that. But I think that would be pretty cool. Just saying.
I mean, hey, DC is coming out with their Aquaman movie, so to compete with that, Namor.
Oh, yeah. Namor, yes! I would love to see a Namor movie.
I mean, the thing is, he's similar to Aquaman in a lot of ways, but I have no faith in DC anymore, and so I don't really think the Aquaman, even though I know nothing about it so far, I just don't have high hopes for the Aquaman movie. So maybe Namor could do the underwater superhero thing, right?
Yeah, that would be great.
After Aquaman messes it up.
Yeah.
I don't want Aquaman to mess it up. I'm just afraid that that's what's going to happen.
I think that would be a great idea. Because that's like one of the very first Marvel characters. Making a movie out of him would be really cool. I guess similarly, I'd really like to see a Human Torch movie. But not like Fantastic Four, the original Human Torch. Like the android guy.
Yeah.
That would be very cool.
Captain America, Human Torch, and Namor, big three from at the beginning.
Yes, an Invaders movie. That would be very cool. A set in World War II.
I was also thinking maybe like if they wanted to keep the Avengers movies going, do like a Secret Wars movie, or
yes,
something with Secret the Scrolls. Wars?
Yeah, with the Scrolls. Yes, that's I don't know. The weird thing, though, the problem with a lot of this is that Fox either owns all the rights or partial rights, so Marvel would have to, at the most, do, like, some bargaining with them.
Or maybe they could do, I mean, maybe they could just do some legal actions and change the Skrulls to the Krulls. Brand new alien race!
The Krulls. I don't know, but I'd really like to see an Invaders movie. Because, like, we saw World War II in the MCU with Captain America. But, you know, and I like that movie probably more than a lot of people do. But I do think that it had, like, a little too much weird Hydra tech in it that was just too much weird CGI that I didn't super like. So I'd like to see a more, like, grittier version of World War II, you know?
Yeah.
Just like more real, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, I know.
With you know, Atlantean kings and flying flaming men. More real. But that would be super awesome. I don't know. Well, then there's like, you know, obviously, there was talk about a year ago when the Fantastic Four movie like completely flopped, that maybe Marvel would get the rights back. But there hasn't been any further talk about that, so I don't know. But if they were to do that,
there's a possibility that even if Marvel doesn't give the rights back now, some point in the future they could.
Yeah. So I mean, I would love to see a Fantastic Four movie, like done right. You know.
Yeah, we've had four of them. Four. Roger Corman, the two with Jessica Alba and Chris Evans, and then this newest one, maybe fifth time's the charm. If it's done by Marvel.
Exactly, yeah. The only thing, I would love to see, and I'd love it to be kind of like, maybe sort of like a comedy, sort of, just because I feel like that's, at this point, the only way you can do the Fantastic Four, because if anyone sees it.
Their name has been so besmirched by the last.
Exactly, at this point. Yeah. You'd have to take it sort of an off-the-wall comedy sort of approach to it, and I would be fine with that, because really, like, that's a great way to go about this. Because that's what they are. They're like a funny, wacky family sort of thing. And that's a great way to do that. And maybe even, like, make it take place in the 60s. Like, make it kind of like, you know, like 60s wackiness. I think that'd be really cool to see.
That would be cool, but I'm not sure how well that would fit in with the universe.
I know. It's like, you know, you'd have to account for, like, well, then how come no one remembers them, you know, by the time Iron Man comes around? I don't know. I just think that'd be like a cool thing to see happen. And obviously, that may not happen anytime soon. But I feel like that could, because I mean, Fox isn't going to be able to make terrible Fantastic Four movies forever, you know?
Oh,
they're going to have
you
to
watch.
eventually stop. I know, it's like,
but
saying that, like, dares them.
Yeah, I've got some heroes that I'd like to see, like, I'm just going to list them off, but I'd like to see, but I almost think that they would make better Netflix shows than movies.
Yeah.
Which, I know this is going to sound weird, because I was asking about, are we having an oversaturation of TV superheroes, but but here's my list. Moon Knight, Cloak and Dagger.
Hmm. Yes, yes.
Wait, did I say Moon Knight or Midnight? Because I meant Moon Knight, but I'm
yeah, Moon Knight would be amazing. Because there's so much you can do with that character, because every time someone, like, every time they bring him back, they're always doing something completely different with him. Like, he started off as, like, a Batman ripoff sort of thing, then he became, like, this, like, weird, like, supernatural, well, actually, then he became, like, a multiple personality disorder guy in, like, the 2000s, and he was, like, kind of crazy, sort of, and now he's, like, literally crazy. He's, like, in an insane asylum sort of thing. So there's so much you can do with this character, and he is very cool, but, and yeah, that would be, that, you know, that's the thing we haven't even talked about, like, you know, the Netflix series, you know, like, if they continue, where could they go, you know? I don't think they're going to cross over with the movies anytime soon, although that would be very cool to see, you know, Daredevil
yeah.
with all the others up there.
Charlie Cox, who plays Daredevil, said that he would be interested. Before Civil War came out, he said that he'd be interested in being in it, but he hadn't gotten the call.
Mm-hmm. Maybe they're waiting for Infinity War to involve everybody, you know?
That'd be really cool.
That would be very cool.
Not sure how
yeah.
much Daredevil could do against Thanos, but hey.
Yeah.
So.
I think he was actually in the Infinity War comic, and I'm not really sure. I can't remember if he actually did anything or not.
See, Infinity War or Infinity Gauntlet, because there's so many Infinity things in Marvel. Because he wasn't in I'm pretty sure he wasn't in the battle with Thanos. It's been a while since I've read it. I'd have to go back, but I'm pretty sure that, like, whenever Thanos does the thing, I'm trying to avoid spoilers for people who haven't read it.
Spoilers for this 30-year-old comic.
Yeah, well, still, it could lead to spoilers for the movie. I don't know. But whenever Thanos does something that incapacitates a lot of heroes, and I think Daredevil may have been among them.
Okay, yeah, that's right. I remember.
I'm pretty sure he was, but I could be wrong. It's been a while since I've been there. But
yeah.
the movie could be different. We could see Daredevil.
Yeah, and then Cloak and Dagger is also an awesome, like, that's a cool, that would be a cool, like, buddy show movie. I think that would probably work better as a Netflix show also. I think, again, though, Fox owns the rights to them also.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
Because
they're technically mutants.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I know, it sucks.
It's like, I keep thinking of these characters that I want to see, whether they be heroes or villains, but then I keep realizing that they probably fall into somebody else's jurisdiction whenever it comes to movies. Like, I don't really care so much about the Fantastic Four so much as I care about some of their villains. Like, Doctor Doom.
Like Galactus.
Galactus, Doctor Doom. These are big guys in the Marvel universe. Like, I wish that they would show up, but they can't because Fox exists.
Yeah. Here is, obviously I've said Ghost Rider like a million times for Netflix would be awesome, but that might happen, but I don't know. You know, now that Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is doing it, it's like it's not gonna happen. How about this? How about a show based on like the horror aspects of Marvel? Like, not really a superhero show at all, just but still, like, based in the Marvel Universe. So I'm thinking, like, Werewolf by Night, Man-Thing sort of thing. Maybe just, like, a show where they are all kind of in it.
I don't know,
like,
but...
What?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just going to say, I don't know, that could work, but I feel like we're slowly straying from the topic. We were talking about the movies at first.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's the thing. Like, they go hand in hand. I don't know. But, I think that, I forgot what I was going to say. Okay. What'd you say?
Do you remember now?
No, I don't. Okay, well, we'll just move right along then.
Here's something that I think would be interesting to do in a phase four, getting back to that.
Mm-hmm.
S.H.I.E.L.D. gets fully rebuilt, but who rebuilt it? Norman Osborn, who is now
the enemy. Yeah.
Because now we can have Spider-Man people in the MCU. So kind of do that story. Like, you know, like have the heroes come back to Earth to find that in their absence, S.H.I.E.L.D. has been reformed, or S.W.O.R.D. has been formed, whatever you want to call it. And in order to protect against major threats like Thanos once again. But Nick Fury is no longer at the top. Now it's Norman Osborn, a.k.a. the Green Goblin. Is for a while.
Yeah,
that's what he was.
That's actually really good. I'd be super down for that. Dark Reign was like a really cool idea to me when it was out in the comics. Because you know you have like a Dark Avengers, so you have like villains taking on the mantles of the various Avengers that you know. That would be very cool. Maybe, you know, I think I heard, actually, that they did, that, you know, someone at least is considering doing that over at Marvel after Phase 3. And that really would be the perfect time to do it, too.
Yeah, I think that would be awesome.
Yeah. I don't know.
Should they? Right now, I'm not really a big fan of doing this because it seems way too early in the universe, but maybe by Phase 4... an Agent Venom movie?
Oh, yeah. Agent Venom is, like, actually kind of a really cool character, you know?
Yeah, that's why I said maybe they should do it.
Because, like, you got Flash Thompson, who is, like, a classic douchebag, and then he becomes, like, this war hero, and then he becomes an actual superhero with Venom. That would be cool also. That'd be cool as well.
But I feel like they should, like, I don't know, maybe have, like... I don't know. I feel like it's still too early to do it right now. I feel like we need a little bit more Spider-Man, because right now we haven't even seen Flash Thompson.
Yeah.
In the MCU.
Well, you know, Sony's still trying to push through the Venom movie. Not Agent Venom, just regular Venom. Which I still don't know how you can make a Venom movie. I just... Guys.
Unless you do, like, a Venom versus Carnage movie.
But still, like, how can you make a movie out of that? It's just, it's like Freddy versus Jason.
It's not a good idea to make a movie out of it. And especially, like I said, not this early. I mean, you should put Venom in a Spider-Man movie and actually put him in a good Spider-Man movie and do a good job with him and then make us want to see more of him.
Right, like, it's such a good thing that Marvel actually has control, or some control, over Spider-Man now.
I'm really hoping that Sony's just, like, sitting back and collecting a paycheck and just letting Marvel do the rest.
Like, if Fox wasn't so stubborn and stupid, they could be doing that too, and then we could have good X-Men movies, but, you know, whatever. I forgot, this isn't my idea. I heard it from... I was watching a video by Mr. Sunday Movies, who makes awesome comic book-related movies, or videos. You should go check him out if you haven't. He actually had a cool idea related to this topic, like an Old Man Logan movie in the MCU, which which is weird, because, you know, Fox is making an Old Man Logan in name only, really, movie right now. But if you read Old Man Logan, the story, it's predominantly characters that the MCU owns, and almost no characters that Fox actually can use. So you could almost just switch Logan out with any other character and just do it that way. And then you could have a really cool, like, post-apocalyptic storyline just kind of set in, like, the far-flung possible future, you know? Like, maybe that would be a cool way to, like, explore, you know, possible futures in the MCU, you know?
Yeah, I'd be interested in seeing a time travel story.
Yeah. Like, you could insert it in, like, some sort of movie where, like, say, I don't know, Captain America gets transported to the future and, like, you know, sees this all take place, you know? I don't know. I think that'd be pretty cool. So, yeah. Do you got anything else?
Not really. I mean, it really is hard to, like, speculate about what Phase 4 should be whenever we're officially one movie into Phase 3. Still weirds me out that Ant-Man is part of Phase 2. Like, because I thought it was supposed to be the start of Phase 3, but apparently Captain America Civil War is the start of Phase 3. But, you know, what a way to start the phase.
Well, yeah.
But, you know, I mean, we've got so far to go before this phase is done that it's kind of hard to speculate. So I'm kind of running out of ideas.
Yeah. Do you think we'll ever see that Black Widow movie?
No. I don't know. I mean, maybe. I mean, I feel like right now they can't really squeeze it in.
Right.
At this point, like, into their schedule, so they'd have to do it in Phase 4, and I'm not sure if Scarlett Johansson wants to play the character for that long.
Yeah.
And, like I said, I feel like if they were going to do a Black Widow movie, like, right now would have been the best time. Like, I think I said it during the Civil War review episode we did, because, spoiler alert for Civil War, she's kind of left in the wind, because she left Tony's group, but she hasn't, from what we've seen, she hasn't met up with Captain America's group, so she's on her own. So maybe while she's on her own, something from her past comes back to attack her or haunt her, and she has to go through this whole, all these events where she has to finally fully face her past and defeat it or something like that, you know, just general, very vague concepts. But I feel like now would be a really good time because she's on her own to see Black Widow movie. But obviously they can't rush one out right now. I mean, they're not in DC, so they're not going to rush one out without having planned it well in advance. And since they haven't, you know, it's not going to happen. It's just wishful thinking.
I don't know. I mean, I'm not too disappointed that it's not going to happen. I mean, I would have been okay with it, but it wasn't, like, something I was super, like, you know, vying for to happen. But
yeah, at least now we're getting the Captain Marvel movie to, like, have a strong female character be the lead in a movie in Marvel.
Yeah, it's funny. It's actually one thing DC is going to beat Marvel to is having a female superhero as, like, the star of the movie.
Yeah, but just because you have this is how I've always said it. There's a huge difference between a strong female character and a female character who is strong. So only time will tell whether Wonder Woman ends up being a strong female character who is well-defined, who has her own motivations, or she's just a female character who is strong if she's one-dimensional and she's pretty much just defined by how strong she is and how sexy she looks.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, like, I just have no faith in DC right now. I would not be surprised if Ms. Marvel ends up being the first movie to have a strong female character and actually be a good movie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, I don't know, the Avengers 4 is going to be, like, a major turning point, either way, you know, no matter what happens, and it's going to be really interesting to see, Exactly, yeah. It's gonna be really interesting to see how they handle it. I'm really interested to see how, like, you know, how are they gonna deal with, you know, different actors walking away? Are they gonna recast? Are they gonna pass on to new versions of those superheroes?
Are they gonna get on their hands and...
What?
Are they gonna get on their hands and knees and beg Robert Downey Jr. to stay?
You're gonna stay here till you die, Downey Jr. Oh yeah.
I just pictured Robert Downey Jr. like signing a contract without fully reading it, and in the contract, like, Marvel like has like this clause that's like, when you die, we get your body. So they just like make Robert Downey Jr.'s body into a puppet and then just use like clips of him talking to like do all his dialogue.
Yeah.
So he's literally playing Iron Man for the rest of however long the MCU is going on.
Basically,
possibly forever.
Yeah. Possibly forever. That's just it. It may last longer than both of us. We're talking about it now, but when we die, it will only remain.
Yeah, I mean, it could last, I don't know. I'm not a psychic. I don't know what's going to happen. It could last, the MCU could last until the end of time, until the world is destroyed or humanity is gone. I don't know.
Yeah. And that's fine by me, Carson.
As long as they keep the quality up, it's fine by me, too. Because I'm going to be disappointed that I won't see the new movies.
Yeah. Okay, so that's basically our main topic for today. What do you guys think will happen in the MCU after Phase 3?
Put it in the comments below.
Yeah, or tweet at us on our Twitter accounts, at the Mordork Podcast. Okay, well, time for our final segment, which is recommendations. So this has been a busy week for both of us, I'm sure. But, Carson, what is your recommendation?
Okay, this is kind of weird because I am going to make a future recommendation.
Oh, okay.
It may sound a little weird at first, but I will explain my reasoning.
Okay.
This week I have been playing the Attack on Titan video game that just came out for PS4 this week. I've been really enjoying it. I don't think it's a great game in the way that, like, say, The Witcher 3 or Skyrim or something like that is a great game. But as a fan of Attack on Titan, I have really enjoyed the game thus far. I think that it does a good job of capturing the feeling of swinging around on the ODM gear. Mm-hmm. And so I think it's really fun, and so I recommend it to people who like the Attack on Titan anime, but it's a future recommendation because I haven't finished the game yet, but that's only because I haven't played it very much. It's a pretty short game. I can tell that it's a pretty short game, and so I don't think it's quite worth the full price yet, given the amount of content, so I would probably wait for it to come down in price a little bit, or buy a used copy or something. But if you're a fan of the show and like video games and have a PS4, I'd recommend it.
That sounds pretty cool.
You can find a place still rents video games.
Yeah, I saw a trailer for it. It looked really cool. I don't play very many video games, but when I do, they're usually all right.
Pokemon.
Yeah,
they're usually Pokemon.
They're usually Pokemon, basically, yeah. Okay, so I didn't do a lot this week, but as far as, like, reading stuff or watching, but I did see a movie called Mechanic Resurrection. Have you heard about this?
I have not.
You haven't? Okay.
No.
It's actually a sequel to a movie that came out, like, 10 years ago or something, called The Mechanic, and it's like starring Jason Statham.
I know what that is. For some reason, I just blanked whenever you said the name, but now I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, okay. It's like, think Jason Bourne, but Jason Statham instead. And instead of like having a mission or a reason to be, He just kind of goes around doing things. It's not that good, but it's like, if you want, and I mean like a truly mindless action movie, that's like what this is. Actually, after I saw it, it like reminded me of a video game, because there's like, he basically has to take down three different bad guys and make them look like accidents, because that's his thing. He's basically an assassin who makes all the killings look like accidents. So each person he kills, it's like got to be in sort of an interesting way, except for the first one where he basically just strangled him. So I was like, that's not really an accident, is it? It's what it is, you know. It's kind of like a video game. It's like watching a video game but not playing it. So, I guess that's my recommendation. It's not awful, I'll say that. I had a lot more fun in that movie than I did in, say, Fantastic Four. So, it's better than that. So go watch it, Carson.
I mean, that's not saying much.
No, it really isn't.
I'm sorry if I've been interrupting you. Like, my headphones that I'm using to hear you are really cheap because my good ones died, and so like the audio cuts out every now and then. So I may be interrupting
here.
You. So I apologize if I put that throughout this.
Yeah, like the internet's not very good where we're recording right now, so it's like we're a little like off sync sort of. Which is probably why there's a few awkward silences. But anyways, we'll try to fix that somehow. Anyways, guys, that's about it for this week. Like we said, if you have any thoughts on what the MCU's future is going to look like, leave it in the comments below or tweet at us at our Twitter account. Next week we'll be talking about something different. Isn't that right, Carson?
Probably.
Probably.
Yeah,
probably
I've actually got... I've got some things in the semi-near future that I'd like to talk about.
Yeah, there you go. Semi-new things in the future. That's what we guarantee here at the Mordork Podcast.
I guarantee nothing. You get nothing, you peasants. You get what I give you and nothing else. Do you hear me? Nothing.
Yeah, you tell him, Carson. Okay, that's about it for this week. Until next time, take us out. Say bye.
The most confrontational I've ever been, like just yelling into the void of the internet. Bye.